What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel for another video. So I've spent quite a bit of time with the ROG Ally over these past few days during launch week, and I put together a few tips that could be helpful to people that might be new to ROG Ally or maybe even new to Windows, as I've actually been running into that as well. So when you first set up your ROG Ally, you're going to be greeted with the typical Windows 11 setup, which does take some time to go through and get done. But it's not all that bad. It's really when you get into the updates after that, that things get a little bit trickier and you really need to go through and get them all done. So once you get that initial setup done and you're on your desktop, which will look a little different than mine here as I'm already done, it's time to get into updates. So let's go to screen capture here so that you can see a little bit better what I'm doing. And Armory Crate is the first thing we're gonna take a look at. This should automatically open up when you boot up the ROG Ally. And this is kind of your hub for your game library, settings, things like that, all of your controller support, customization. But if we go over here to content and update center, this is where you're gonna wanna find all the little updates involved with Armory Crate. These can be really important as it does its thing with controller support and other things with Windows, things with your lighting for your RGB, and of course the just Armory Crate SE updates itself. So definitely day one, and every week or two, check for updates if they don't automatically pop up there. Over in the My ASUS app is another big one that you need to go into and make sure you have your updates. These will have some very critical updates for your system, so you want to make sure you go in here and check live update for that. Now, mine doesn't show any here because I've already done them all, but there were a ton of updates. I had like two or three BIOS flashes or updates happen, firmware, GPU drivers, all kinds of things that happened in here day one. So again, hit that up and also check it periodically. The other thing that you're going to want to do is go into Windows updates in your settings here. Now, you may opt to not want to keep updating Windows. I understand why a lot of people don't want to continue rolling through with Windows updates. But when you first get your device and you first set it up, you should go through and let it do its updates. Again, you won't see them all here, but I had a couple of dozen updates to do day one, and a lot of them really fixed a lot of issues Windows would have had with communicating with the device. After that, if you want to hold off a little bit, I get it. But go check this out as well on launch when you first set up. The AMD software here isn't as important, but I love that we're running full adrenaline with all support here from AMD, so you are able to use this to check current versions of driver and software updates here. You can also use their overlay if you don't like the Armory Crate overlay or anything like that, so you can go in here and check that as well. One of the final places would be your Windows Store, and this thing can have a ton of updates depending on all the apps, especially on day one. But again, things for like game services, Xbox app, a bunch of other things, you really do want to go through and do all those updates in the store as well. But those are pretty much the spots you want to take care of it with Armory Crate, My ASUS, Windows Updates, Windows Store, and go through and really make sure that you have everything updated, ready to go for day one. Now our next tip is something I've already done a lot of, but when you first boot into Windows, you won't see them here, but there's a ton of apps like Prime Video, TikTok, Facebook Messenger, a lot of things that you might want to just go through, right click and uninstall immediately. I go through and try to get rid of as many apps as possible. You can go into settings, you can go into all apps here, just find anything that you're not going to use or you don't want taking up space or using resources and get it off your system. I'm not done cleaning up my Windows yet, but I've got a good start here. Also, if you go into settings and apps and installed apps, you'll get another more comprehensive list here you can go through as well. There's other great ways to debloat Windows, but rather than get into all that in this video, I'm just reminding you that when you first get in, uninstall anything you don't want on there and get rid of it off the bat. It'll save you some space and save you some resources in the long run. Now, also, I would recommend going into your task manager. I have mine pinned to my taskbar here. You can do Control Alt Delete or search for it. And go into your startup apps. And you're gonna wanna go in there and just make sure you disable anything that you don't want starting up on startup, especially after you install your own programs and really customize this thing. Check this every now and then and make sure nothing is coming on during boot that you don't want to. That'll really help you out as well. Now, this next tip is for the SD cards, which really helped me out on launch day. But before we get into that, we got a quick word from today's video sponsor. Today's video sponsor is Maximum Settings. They offer a Linux-based cloud gaming PC that you can connect to with almost any device using Moonlight. I've tested them for a few years here on the channel and have always had a great experience. They've recently added monthly packages, which I think is a great value for customers and something we've been asking for, but also maintain their hourly rates as well for those who would rather go that way. So there's options there for you. Of course, you get a full-blown desktop here with Linux, and you'll have things like Lutris, Heroic, and Steam, and others to really manage all of your launchers and your games, and it works really well. If you are coming over from the Steam Deck, a lot of these processes will feel familiar to you. Their gaming performance has been really good, especially on their higher end hardware, and they're always looking to upgrade. You can jump in and play a lot of your favorites and expect some really good performance, and you're able to use Moonlight to really tweak your experience. I'm happy to see a company really take the reins and put a gaming PC for Linux in the cloud. If you're interested, there'll be a link in the description to go check them out. So SD card download speeds can certainly be an issue, especially on this SD card, but on the left here you can see before and on the right after I fixed the SD card driver issues, and it certainly helped fix a lot of the start stop and issues I was having with downloads here. So if you go over to the ROG Ally site, you can get the drivers and tools you need. All the information for this came with your ROG Ally in the box. You go over to the site and we got card reader, Genesis card reader driver. For whatever reason, this doesn't seem to be part of my ASUS, or it didn't install properly or whatever. So download this, open the file and install it. I've already installed it, so I'm not going to do it again, but you click OK, follow a couple quick prompts, and it's very fast, and then you have to restart your Ally. This should do a lot to really help stabilize your download without a bunch of start stops and that kind of thing. Depending on your SD card, obviously, they're not all built the same, there's different speeds, and this isn't a UHS 2, it's a 1, but this driver certainly did help me out. Armory Crate and Command Center come ready to go on your Ally. Armory Crate with the right button over here, and Command Center with the left button over there, and that's going to bring those up as you need them. Now, Armory Crate is used to handle all of your controller support and RGB lighting controls and all of that, and it's how you can customize all the shortcuts in your Command Center, which we'll take a look at in another tip. But I really advise jumping into Armory Crate. Go into your library, go into your settings here where you have a lot of options for connection, audio, Aura Sync, lighting, adjustments to Command Center, which again we'll take a look at in another tip. The update center I showed you, along with a lot of other featured items in here and system information. So I just recommend just taking a little bit of time, hanging out in Armory Crate, looking through all the different settings and things you can do. And when it comes to controller customization, there's a lot you can do in here to make things work the way you want, which we'll also take a look at later as well. You can sort your library here also and make that look how you want, but it's really handy and they're doing a great job with Armory Crate so far here on the Ally. I recommend getting in and really just kind of learning as much as you can about it. Now, as far as our next thing, we do have that Command Center I was talking about with the left button. Now, we're on screen cap here, so you can see a little easier what I'm doing, but you can bring up your Command Center and change your operating mode, which is going to be your turbo and performance and all of that. You've got your control modes, which can be handy, switching between desktop and controller and auto. Game profiles, the ability to bring up your keyboard, your real-time monitor to bring up stats, your FPS and all of that. We've got FPS limiters, show desktop, FSR. We got all kinds of good stuff in your Command Center. So just like learning Armory Crate, Command Center goes right along with that. Spend some time with Armory Crate and Command Center and just get used to how they work, and it'll make your experience that much better on the Ally. Now you can also customize this Command Center as I was talking about earlier. So if you come over here, you can actually use your finger or your mouse or your control, whatever you want. You can drag and drop these around and sort them and move them as you wish in what order, which can be really handy when you have certain things you want to bring up quickly in Command Center. You can also add or change these as well. So you have all the options in Edit Command Center here to add your screenshot, microphone, record screen, LED brightness for your RGB. I'll click that and add it here so you can see it get added. But you can add up to a few more items here, shift everything around, and make it look as you want. So really great stuff for Command Center. The next tip I want to look at is the per game controller customization. And while I won't go too deep here, I think it'll give you enough of an idea. I really needed this for NVIDIA GeForce Now so I could bring up my overlay and quit games while I was in the game. So if I click X there to customize this thing, I have key mapping, configuration, all this kind of stuff I can do here. So for my key mapping, you can see our secondary function buttons down here with M1 and M2. And you hold those down and you hit another button for your shortcut. Now you can see up here at right trigger, I've already set macro 1. So I've set that to be my control N to bring up my GeForce Now overlay. Next, I'm going to do the right bumper. I'm going to make that my Alt F4 to close the game. So I click on that. You can do this any way you want with your controller, your finger, mouse. Secondary assignment here, and I'm going to go over to combine keys. There's a ton of different stuff you can actually throw in here, but I'm going to go to combine keys. You can see my first macro here. I'm going to go ahead and do macro 2, and we're going to set that. So I'm going to click here on the little edit button, it's going to bring up a keyboard. This is really cool. You don't need a keyboard attached to do this. You're able to just pick one button at a time here. So I'm going to go ahead and do my Alt F4 for being able to close games in GeForce Now. So I'll click each of those. That'll be a combined key. I'll hit back, and you can see it's now in my macro 2. And then I set that. I just click on it, and now I've got that set as well. Let me show you how that works by jumping over into GeForce Now. But you can assign and set so many different things and actions to happen. It's really handy. You can see me here now using my shortcuts to bring up my overlay. And then I can also use my right button that we just set to go ahead and Alt F4 and quit the game. Super handy to be able to adjust this for all kinds of apps and games in Armory Crate. And just jump in and get used to using that. You can always reset to defaults if you need to. Okay, so an easy one, but a lot of people have overlooked. I even overlooked it during my initial setup when I needed a keyboard. But these back paddles are your shortcut buttons that we were just talking about setting up. But there's some defaults. So if you hold that down and hit up on the D-pad, you get your keyboard. If you hold one down and hit right on the D-pad, you get Task View Manager, which is super handy for closing windows and seeing what you have open. And if you hold one of those back buttons down and hit down on the D-pad, you get your Task Manager, which again is super handy if you have issues or something's froze up or you need to close a program. And there's a bunch of other defaults as well. If you hold that down and hit A, it's a screenshot. There's other ones programmed in. So definitely dive in and learn those shortcuts as well, along with Command Center. It just makes the ALLY experience on Windows that much better. All right, guys, that's all the tips I have for now in this video. They're pretty simple ones, but just during my initial setup and first few days with the ALLY, I kind of felt like these things were kind of good to point people toward that might not be super familiar. We'll probably do some more in-depth, harder kind of tips down the road for Windows and Armory Crate and all of that. Might get deeper into things if you guys want to see a lot more with controller customization, adding different apps into Armory Crate. There's just dozens and dozens of things we can get into here, but hopefully this is a decent start if you're looking for some ideas to get started on your ALLY. Maybe you just have missed some of these things or hadn't picked them up yet. But anyways, guys, thanks a lot for coming to check out the video. As always, I really appreciate it, and I'll see you in the next one.